growing up in the ag industry every day, I saw animals every day. I worked with animals every day. I cared for them. I fed them. That was my job. So when I saw factory farming, I saw this as the future of agriculture. I saw this as a way for farmers to get ahead, a way for them to put in the same amount of work, the same amount of money, the same amount of feed, and get twice as much benefit out of it. But what I didn't saw was how it was affecting the animals. I didn't see how the animals were being mistreated. One day when I was scrolling through Twitter, I saw a video of various factory farms around the nation. And what I saw was a lot of animals being mistreated, a lot of animals being abused, and they weren't being treated the way they were, the way they should. So most people, when they think of factory farms, they think it's just necessary because without it, we can't feed the growing population and more hunger will become a bigger problem. But factory farming is harmful to animals and the environment. This is an unnecessary strain on the environment and the animals. So people, when they think of factory farming, basically what they think of, it's the easiest way for us to grow food. It's the easiest way for us to get milk, eggs, and meat, just because you can put in the same amount of work, but you get twice as much, but you're abusing the animals. So I have a quote from the article of Farm Forward. It says, factory farming now accounts for more than 99% of farm animals raised and slaughtered in the United States. So this is a lot of animals that are being abused. Another reason is people say that it's easy and it's cheap. So farmers are taking the easy way out, the cheapest way, so that they can raise the food. But they're not taking into account how the animals are being treated and the health of the products that they're producing. And most people, when they look inside the factory farms, they just say they're just animals. They don't have feelings. They don't have emotions. And that people, and since we are superior to animals, we think we can treat them however we want, and we can do whatever we want to them. And without factory farming, we would starve otherwise, because we wouldn't have enough food. But none of this is necessary. To start, I have a quote from Why Factory Farming Isn't What You Think. 69% of consumers responding to a Context marketing survey said they would be willing to pay more for food that promises to be produced at a higher ethical standard. So people want to buy food that's ethically produced. They want to buy meat where the animals weren't abused, maybe from family farms that are locally, and not these big, large corporations that are abusing animals. So there's different substitutes for milk and meat. Like you can buy almond milk or anything vegan that doesn't require animals to be abused or slaughtered inside these factory farms. And since technology is increasing, which we all know, farmers can produce, or their yields for crops and vegetables and fruits are increasing dramatically. We can produce more plants than we ever could, so we can feed the growing population just off plants, which is healthier for us because a plant-based diet is healthier because the meat coming out of the factory farms isn't healthy because it's tainted with antibiotics, and since the animals are abused and everything, they're not the animals aren't healthy themselves, so then the meat's not healthy. And animals can feel joy, pain, and anger. It's the same thing when you go home and you pet your dog and he wags his tail. You see that he's happy. He's obviously happy. But if you go and you hit your dog, you can see that he's sad. His tail starts wagging and he runs away. This is the same for every animal. Every animal can feel pain and joy. So inside the factory farms, these animals are miserable. They're often angry, and life is pointless for them. So we need to take a step back and look at where our food is coming from and how it was treated. Factory farms aren't necessary because technology helps us increase the yield of crops. Factory farming produces unhealthy products. Factory farming allows animals to be mistreated. So the next time you eat a hamburger, I want you to think about where it came from and how the animal was treated, and how it was slaughtered for you to eat that hamburger. Thank you. because inside these factory farms, they jam a large amount of animals into a small pen just so that they're fed quickly, and then the more they put in there, obviously, the more they can produce. So they're too close together, and then disease spreads easier.
So a lot of like U.S. like products are exported to other countries. Do you think a lot of other countries around the world really care about the factory farms, or do they really have an opinion on it?
I don't think it's much as that. I don't know if it's they're educated on what's happening inside the United States, because I lived in the agriculture world for so long and I didn't even know. So maybe they don't know what's going on inside U.S. factory farms.
If you did stop factory farming, how would that affect like the consumer, like the person that would be buying like the product? That would be like, would it increase prices, or like would it be a different type of meat?
It'd probably increase prices, but like I said in my quote, that 69% of people would pay more for meat that's ethically produced. So I don't think it's more that people would mind that if it went up too high, maybe they would stop buying meat. But if it went up a little bit, I think most people would be okay with it because the meat is ethically produced.
I'm going to stem off that question really quick. Sorry, Brandon. The 31%, the other people, where do you think those people fall in the income range, people who maybe would not want this to happen?
I'd say they'd probably fall in the lower end of the income.
And so all the options you're providing, like becoming a vegan, eating all organic, those things cost a lot more. So what's going to happen to those people who are in the lower socioeconomic ladder? So those who people who would be deemed poor, how are they going to afford this lifestyle if they don't have cheaper meat and products available to them?
I know the government has like food stamps and stuff like that, but I'm not saying that's what they should do. But I'm not sure on the prices of groceries because I don't go to the store. But I'm pretty sure vegetables aren't as expensive as where meat would be. So I don't think they would have a problem moving towards a plant-based diet, whereas if they were just eating more meat now, if they moved over to the plant, I don't think it'd be that big of a change in cost.
So what about the accessibility to meat? Like if they stopped factory farming, would it be harder for people to get the bulk that they get of the meat? If you can buy bulk, is it going to be harder for them to have accessibility to it if they stop factory farming?
I think yeah, but family or for to be a factory farm, you have to have over 500 head of cattle or 500 head of pigs, and then it's different for chickens and dairy cows. But so if you're buying from a family farm, it's not necessarily a factory farm, so the animals aren't being mistreated and stuff like that. So if we got rid of factory farms, the family farms would come back because they're disappearing because large corporations are buying them out. So if they were coming back, I don't think the accessibility would be open.
All right, thank you.